Hey guys, King DZ here, and tonight we're going to do a special video over one of the newer G Fuel Collector boxes that they came out with. This had finally came in the mail a few days back, and I had just been busy with everything, so now that it's late at night and I can't really sleep all that well, I decided, you know what, might as well make it productive. So I'm going to do a special opening with it, show everything inside the new collector's box, and we'll just see what you think, and see what I think about the flavor, and see if it's pretty good. Now what we have here is a special Naruto Rasengan. I hope I'm saying it right. I hadn't watched this in forever, but I had saw it on there and it was one of the ones I hadn't got. But it's a special Naruto Rasengan. I'm not quite, I don't quite remember how to say it, but we have that here. And here's the front of the art and how it looks on the top. And on the side, I think it's pretty neat. It actually shows some of the characters that go with them. And I hadn't seen this in a long, long time. I'd seen the first season or two growing up as a kid, back when we had cable. And everything after that just kind of, whenever it showed up on TV, basically, like on Toonami, is when I'd see it. So it wasn't like religiously watching it. It was just more, if it was on, I'd go ahead and watch it. But they do seem familiar. Their names, I guess because it's late at night, don't quite remember it. And then here's on the other side, which I think shows how he looks now on the right versus how he looked as a kid then. And the 20th anniversary. I'm like, wow, has it really been 20 years? I guess so. And to me, this is cool. It shows all the characters in the original anime, it looks like. There is a lot to go over, a lot of faces I remember. I remember some names, but I don't quite remember just everyone, shoot. Though, at least just the majority of them all seem familiar. Fun fact, Gaara is my favorite right there. I just like him, I think the dude's cool. So now that we've got that out of the way, we're gonna go ahead and open this up, and we're gonna see what all we have inside. Also, I have my shaker cup. Have my shaker cup and my water ready on the side. So we can go ahead and get going. See how it works. Okay, cool. I like the... Right off the bat, I think it's pretty neat. Now, I'm quite sure if it comes with, like, a sticker or anything. I think it might just come inside the box. Or, like, I don't know if it's a special sticker or not. I feel like it would, but you never know. Hey, okay, this is kind of cool. So this is the metal. Hey, that's neat. Hand wash only. See, every other bag of, or every other, like, steel shaker cup I've had didn't come with that. It's actually kind of cool. Maybe it's like a sticker. So let me just take this out real quick. Yeah, shoot, this is pretty cool. Jinfu on the side. Sasuke on one side with Naruto on the other. That's cool. I like this. This is neat. I just love the color. The light, the shades of blue and white on there. Oh, dude, this is neat. I like that. How does it look on the side? Okay, it just goes back and forth. Oh, okay. Cool. And a little hand wash only sticker. No, it's not a sticker. It is a piece of paper. Yeah. Cool. Special memento. And now for the moment we've been waiting for. The Rasengan G Fuel for soda ice candy. Soda ice candy. See, I had heard about this flavor a while back when they did this, when they restocked these, and I was wondering. I was like, that sounds faintly familiar. And the more I thought about it, I was like, yeah, it actually sounds really, really familiar. But at the same time, I'm just like, what does it taste like? Like, I've had blue candy before, maybe rock candy, but not anything specific flavor. Maybe it'll be like a blueberry or a blackberry or something like that. Well, no, I would have said something, but soda ice candy. Maybe it'd be like the Ramune sodas, or like the little blue Ramune candies. That's what I'm thinking. Something along the lines of that. Here's how it looks on the side. I don't know, this is the faces. It's neat. And then, I think... Okay, so I noticed... Okay, so it looks normal. It's just maybe it's scrunched up on the shortness of it, because you can kind of see up here too. It looks normal, but in this one spot right in the middle, it looks like it's kind of like squished in. So yeah, it's you can kind of see a divide there. So maybe the art just got switched out. You can kind of see in the middle with the reflection. At the front, looks on the back. All these special vitamins you get. Almost 300% vitamin C. Whoa. Almost 600% vitamin B6. Hold on, camera's acting up. It's a lot of vitamins. I mean, you know what? You probably need this much, especially if you're active and you're doing your gaming, or if you're kind of like me, where you kind of drink this before, or yeah, before work, going into it and stuff. I think it'd be working. I love the art. I like the little, I don't know if this is intentional or not, but I like this little like scrunched up air part. And I really enjoy the art on it too. Yeah, it's cool. All right, so now without further ado, I'm gonna turn this off. We're gonna go ahead and open it up and see what we got. Let me go ahead and do this real quick. If it'll let me, yeah. Come on. Kind of, usually I just use like my thumb. What's it called? I'd use my thumb, the thumbnail, and just like cut it through there, but I want to see if maybe I could just like pop it open somehow. Hold on. Yeah, I know. Oh, maybe I found a way. Hey. Yeah, I just might have found a way to do it. Okay, cool. This will be fairly quick. Least I'd say so. Shoot. Yeah, that's cool. Shoot. Let me try that. Whoa, okay. Alright, we did it. Cool. Here's how it looks. Up on the top. I forgot, it's kind of a little bit of a twist way there. Then you got your special seal. Let's open it up and see what lurks inside. Oh. Wait, I think the air sealed out on it. The moment I tried lifting it up, so it was pretty quick. And inside this, we just have the white powder. Okay, yeah, that smells like. Just the smell of it alone, it smells like. I guess just like rock candy, maybe? It doesn't have a. It smells like sugar, actually. Like, I don't know, like the little stick candies you get, the powdered sugar stick candies, I think, that they look like cigarettes. That's exactly what it smells like sugar, basically. Just powder, sugar, and. I guess more sugar. I guess what candy would smell like and taste like, basically. And now I'm gonna show you how to go about using these, by the way, because even though I've already made a handful of videos on these, if you're looking for a specific G Fuel, like maybe a specific flavor, like this one that I'm doing over, at least this way, if you're not sure or if you are curious enough to want to try it, you'll learn firsthand how to go about doing this. Now, inside of the powder, in each and every one of these tubs, there's supposed to be what's it called? Supposed to be a spoon and a scooper inside. Let me see if I can find it. That's fine, yeah. And it's crazy. Usually, it's like a flavor, like a smell of like a fruit or a candy or something like that. But it's well, just smells like sugar. Okay, I'm gonna have to look for it. Hold on, I have an idea. I'm gonna twist this back on and then just flip it over essentially. Yeah, I hear that candy. Or not the candy, I hear the scooper in the back, in the bottom, so. See if I can get the scooper on top. Oh, wow. One thing I didn't notice, I guess after mixing it up and everything, it looks even more full than before. And I think that scooper might be there. No, it's just fine sugar. Hold on. That is crazy. It's like I made it fluffy. Oh, Well, no, that's... Is that it? No, that's not it. Okay. Okay, I found it. Found it. Alright. Just gotta dig it out. Give me a moment, guys. Alright, so I guess one thing about this is, like, in the past, I didn't notice this, but if you shake these up, like, you shake up the G Fuel and open it up, it suddenly doesn't get, I guess it settles whenever it's, like, shipped and everything, if it stays in the spot specifically too long. And, but once you shake it up, basically, like, I guess grows less powdery. Okay, so you just try and shake this out. And, oh, whoops, my bad. It's gonna be one of those videos. So yeah, each of these G Fuel tubs come with a little scooper with it. Now, if you notice on the top, this is kinda stuck like that. And, that isn't how it's supposed to go, actually. There's a little piece on the side right here. Oh, hold on, turn on the light. There's a little piece on the side right here that if you look for a little reflection, that one that pops it open to where you can actually just scoop it in, and the little funnel part would be like if you're using a water bottle or maybe the opening of the spout of a G Fuel shaker. And for that, it'd be pretty good though. Yeah, it uses either the spout or the water bottle or the top of the spout of a shaker. And for this, it's not supposed to be filled all the way up like that. It's actually supposed to be even with the part that opens. So give me one second. Okay, there you go. Now look at that, see? So it opens up just like that on the side. And this looks to be about an even amount. Maybe I get a little bit more. I might actually just dump it out because it was just packed in there so tightly it might be like concentrated almost. And just get a scoop for it. Whoops, made a mess. I'm not trying to do that. Shoot. Yeah, shoot. You want to have it to be about as even to this as possible. Just more or less. Which I think is actually a pretty good amount from this angle. And then you just pour it into the shaker cup. Now, if you buy the tub by itself, you won't get a shaker cup with it. But if you get the collector's box, you get to use a steel shaker cup. Which actually brings me to my next thing. I rarely ever show these how the inside of these look, and it's so cool how they're innovative on that, to where they actually made the shaker part, or the part that breaks apart on it, they make it actually part of the lid. So as we're like a regular shaker cup like this, it has this on the inside where you put it in, and as you shake it, it kind of moves up and down with it. However, with this, it's installed on the steel shaker cup too. It's pretty cool. I like it. And here's how the inside of it looks. The inside's ordinary, nothing special with it. It's really the design and then having this part in there too. And if you notice, there's quite the size difference, so that also adds more space for it, so you don't have to worry about this as much, I guess. I like it though. Favorite YouTuber right there. So we got that poured in, and we're gonna get the water. Ignore the little ignore the powder mess. That's just gonna I'll deal with that here in a minute. So we're gonna fill this up, pour it in, and then just see how well everything goes. Actually, I can film the pouring to see if it does change colors, because I know sometimes these G Fuel flavors do. See if it turns blue, maybe, or if it's. Oh, hey, yeah. There is a faint blue. Whereas usually if there's no flavor, or not a flavor, usually if there's like a no color to it, it'll just be a pale white, but that's actually a very light blue. Blue from an angle? Very faint blue. If anything, it might be more white, but it is pretty neat though. Okay. Then what you do is you're gonna screw on your lid to your shaker. And here's the second most important part. You want to make sure this top part right there is popped on. So once you hear that pop, you are good to go. Now for the most important part, you're just gonna shake it. Doesn't matter how you go about shaking it. It's just you'll know when it's done. Basically, is when you're done shaking it and you open it up, you'll see that there's bubbles on top. Looks pretty neat. You can go for as long or as little as you want. For me, what's it called? I always want to make sure I've got it just about done. Oh, hey. Okay, so I guess a tiny little water droplet hit the inside of it, and if you look inside there, that little dot, it does turn blue, so it's just a very faint blue on my end. The camera didn't quite show it all that well. But nonetheless, we're going to try it out, shoot. Oh, hold on now. Let me do that. And that should be a bit of a crazy video, actually. I like it when it's like kind of not exactly random, but like, you know, things happen that sort of pop out on it. Okay, so I'd say we're just about done shaking it, maybe a little more. Well, there you go. Making a little bit of a mess everywhere. But actually, I think this is done. So now, without further ado, we're going to open it up. Well, kind of. And see how the inside looks. Now that it's mixed all together, it should be a lot easier to see. Which, yeah, see, the water's bright blue now. Well, it's a lot bluer compared to before. And on top of it, looks pretty good, shoot. It's not as bubbly, though. So maybe it might be like a smoother version, or it might be come out. But let's go ahead and pop this back on. And then we're going to go with it. That's new. That is neat, and I like that. Huh, okay. Some of it's leaking off on the side. Okay, hold on now. And now, without further ado, we'll just go ahead and get a taste. See how the heck this tastes. I'm curious, actually. Here it is, the G Fuel Naruto Rasengan flavored energy drink for gamers. Okay, yeah. Alright, yeah, I was just about right on that flavor. It doesn't taste like fruit. It doesn't taste like anything crazy, I guess. It just tastes like Ramune candy. Yeah. Tastes like the blue Ramune candy from, like, say, the little blue candies you get from Japan, or, like, even those little, like, chewy... There's like, a name for it. It's, like, chewy candy that they brought from Japan to America. And they have different fruit flavors, and one of them is just, I think, Ramune flavored. That's exactly what it tastes like. And it's crazy, because the flavor on it's light as well. We used a full scoop. And for that, and compared to, like, some of the other stronger flavors, the flavor on this is, you taste it, but it's not overwhelming. And the flavor itself is pretty light. I like that. To me, it's cool. I don't mind when they're strong or anything like that, because at least, you know, the flavors come out, especially some of the newer ones that did, where they're, like, they pop out, basically. But this one, it doesn't have to pop out. Or I guess the way, the flavors... The flavor profile of it, it pops out the way it doesn't pop out. It does it pretty mildly. Now, that ain't to say it's a weak flavor. It's not like tasting, you're not being like, oh, well, I can't taste anything on it. No, it's the flavor's there, but it's just, it's on a rating of like how, on a rating of it from like how, I guess, bright or maybe how flashy the flavor is, this is like easily like a five or six. With a 1 being like, oh, it's like, you can't really taste it all. And then 10 being like, oh, maybe I added too much or maybe it's overwhelming. But for that, it's a pretty good flavor, shoot. I like it. I'll get another taste. And compared to some of the other G Fuels where I know some people actually had pretty good complaints on that, saying that some of them tasted really chalky or like powdery even after mixing it or adding more water. This one, it tastes, honestly, just tastes, or not the taste, but like a profile of it just tastes like juice. Yeah, just actually, it tastes kind of like those little powder drink mixes you get. You put them in water and shake it up. However, it doesn't taste anywhere near as chalky as I thought it would be. Chalky or powdery, actually. I think this is actually really cool. This is actually a really neat flavor, especially if you're not into things that are like strong or overwhelming. It's not, it is subtle, but it's sweet. And I think now I'm pretty sure it tastes like a, not Ramune melon, but just plain blue Ramune, like the Japanese soda candy, basically. Soda ice candy. Yeah, that's basically what I thought originally did that, is just came out to it. So, yeah, I think that's actually pretty neat. And that'll be it for today for this. I've actually come to really enjoy this flavor and the neat collaboration with it and the special 20th anniversary for Naruto. And I've seriously come to enjoy the G Fuel cup for this. I just love blue. I love the blue and the various shades of it and white on there and the see Sasuke and Naruto duking it out on it. I think it's awesome. If y'all do get it, if it comes between either getting the collector's box or the tub, get the collector's box. I think it's worth it. Now inside, there wasn't any stickers though, as I was wondering. I didn't even get like just one out of it. But I'd say with everything else, the steel tin, or the steel shaker, and then the tub, and the awesome flavor of it all by itself, I think it's pretty good. To me, I guess I've kind of had a fond preference for like maybe, not exactly flavors that don't pop out, but like more of the not so strong flavors. And this is definitely one of those where it's not like really strong or overwhelming. You just taste it and you're like, oh, that's pretty good actually. It's the flavor's there. It's definitely there, so it's not weak. But it is pretty good, shoot. And if maybe you enjoy Ramune, you might even get a kick out of this. I was wondering if it would taste like just like basically a sugar candy, or maybe even a, maybe like a blue, like maybe rock candy came to mind for some reason, but this is really good. I would recommend this. And well, guess that's it. I'll see y'all later. I'll see y'all next time. I have a few more G Fuel. Have a few more G Fuel reviews I gotta do. I have a couple more collector's boxes. I have one coming out by the time I'm uploading this. I have one coming out, two of them I think coming out in November. I have another one that I think comes out sometime this October. I'm not quite sure when, but I think you'll enjoy it. I've really come to enjoy this collaboration, and I'm looking forward to doing more videos with y'all for G Fuel, and maybe even a few others. Maybe even a few other, like, energy ones. G Fuel is just what I got into first. It kind of led me down this rabbit hole of, like, gaming energy and energy drinks in general, so this is really cool. But we'll look into the future and see how well things go. But for now, y'all have a good day or a good night, and we'll see you next time. Bye.